Guys, this is Teacher Maria, and today we will be working on a poster that delivers a powerful message. Visual art has great convincing power. It is one thing to say or write something, but attaching a strong visual message to it is a different matter. Composition, colors, a subject that calls for compassion all work as an amplifier. These qualities were widely used in the beginning of the 20th century, a period of many wars and changes in people's minds. The very special kind of art that is clearly calling for a particular action has been developed then. Let's look at some of these posters and analyze how they worked.
For example, in this series of posters, we see a strong, heroic man, protective, cares for children, cares for you. And these posters create sympathy for him and his ideas. This man is Adolf Hitler, and his propaganda posters helped him start a war that has taken 75 million lives. In these pictures, we see the same man, but pathetic, disgusting, and weak. We feel no pity for him and no fear. These are the posters that helped defeat him.
These are the posters of the Russian Revolution. They invite peasants and workers to join the Red Army, take everything from the richer class, and kill them for the injustice. These are the posters made by the White Army that try to stop the revolution. They focus on the cruelty of the Red Army, and you feel a desire to protect the civilians from it. So as you can see, the visual art can easily manipulate your mind and make you take a side in a war. But it doesn't have to. You can use it to convince people to save water, protect loved ones from coronavirus, be kind to others, and so on. I decided to make a poster that will convince my family members to always check if the front door is closed and the cats are safe in the house. I started my compositional sketches with a hand gesture and a big no, but soon I realized that I can just use a word stop instead. I made several sketches trying to find the best position for the words and for the cats. And this is my final version where I decided to put all the text together on top and move the cats to the very bottom of the page. Text is a very important part of a poster. It has to be easily readable. This means well drawn. I counted the number of letters, drew blocks for each of them, and drew a horizontal central line, which helps me draw letters better. And repeated this process for the smaller text at the bottom. My first iteration is always in very light pencil, just positioning where the letters will be. After that, I'm using rulers and trying to make my letters look similar, so they belong to one font. I skip the part where I'm drawing cats. You will probably be drawing something else in your poster. And here I am carefully outlining my letters and trying to make a very flat and solid color for them. You have probably noticed that these posters are quite limited in color. They use red to attract your attention and some darker drawing color and maybe a couple of other not so active ones. For the smaller text, I recommend using marker or color pencil. Don't forget to keep your pencil sharp. It's okay to combine different art techniques. Here I'm using pencil drawing and watercolor. You can use acrylics or markers, pencil, and even cut out some photographs, glue them to paper. Remember to note that too many details to your work. In order to deliver a message well, it should be quite minimalistic. All right, this is my finished work, and Rusty approves it. Let's start working on yours. Good luck.